Hillary debuts shocking new look along with something else she didn't know she showed in her selfie. After months of not seeing or hearing much from Hillary Clinton, she finally decided to reveal the strange new version of herself on Snapchat. Sharing a number of awkward selfies along with a surprising message, viewers weren't just shocked by what she looks like now, but also by what else was caught in the picture that Hillary didn't know was showing. Hillary hijacked Women's Day to make her debut, wearing red to show solidarity with all the misguided women who think President Trump has stripped them of their rights. In addition to her big wool coat on what was reportedly a warm Wednesday, she showed off her new haircut she got while in hiding. As uncomfortable as it is seeing a woman like her trying to look sexy in a selfie, it wasn't the only thing scores of people on the internet took notice of. In a torrent of tweets, people online called Hillary out for the message she posted and some snark on her unflattering new do. She used her selfies as the visual to her voice, calling for everyone to stand up, resist, run for office and continue protesting our president. Hillary knows resistance. Voters have resisted her presidency 2 times now, one clever man responded on Twitter. She's right. It's time to resist the non-stop protests, another person pointed out, BizPack Review reported. Others thought that Hillary's haircut looked familiar and then showed where they've seen it before, in a perfectly well-played response to her resistance that she wasn't expecting. It's time for Hillary to go back to the dark hole she just emerged from and stay off Snapchat. Urging everyone to continue protesting our president because she's still sore from losing, is probably not the wisest things to do when you look as ridiculous as she did saying it. She had it coming when she put herself out there like that and it only got worse when she fancied herself as a fashion model. Life hasn't been the same for Hillary Clinton, who seems to have lost herself after the election and is trying to regain some kind of new identity now. In what is perhaps a sad attempt at gaining some self-esteem back, she's seeing herself in the last role anyone ever expected, or wanted, to see her in, showing off the goods as a model. Never in her life, has Hillary been considered a sex symbol, sadly, not even by her own husband. Now in her twilight years, the 69-year-old seems to have traded in her signature, non-envious look for something much younger, after forming an unlikely friendship. To say her latest appearance is an uncomfortable embarrassment is an understatement in the least, nor is she exactly a brand model that's good for business. While she's accomplished many things in academics and politics to get her to the place of running for president, her looks and sense of style never helped her. She has new inspiration now in pop icon Katy Perry, who has a new line out now and picked her political idol to be her model and a pink shoe named after the Democratic nominee, the Washington Examiner reports. Step in and reach for the stars in this dreamy suede pump complete with a lucite heel filled with glistening stars and moons. The description for the $139 shoe called the Hillary reads on Perry's website. Hillary is doing her best to strike a pose in shoes she'd probably never want to be caught dead in, but perfectly complement her tacky pantsuits. It has come down to this for Hillary, who had to trade in her power heels as a potential president, for overpriced shoes that look like business pumps in the front and stripper stilettos in the back. Hillary is the last person who should be in heels considering how unstable she is on her feet, which we saw recently. Call it karma catching up with her, but the truth has a way of revealing itself and there's no way she can disguise it any longer. Hillary had just arrived to go live on a British television show today to promote her new book What Happened When the World Saw What Really Happened, and she was rushed to the hospital. This is going to be a hard one to recover from, and if we're lucky, we may never see her in public again after this major embarrassment. Hillary has been visibly unstable for more than a year, often looking disoriented and unsure on her own 2 feet. She thought she has perfected ways of disguising what's either a major medical issue or perpetual public intoxication, but oftentimes gravity got the best of her. Perhaps she had over-medicated herself ahead of a public interview, or she's just a klutz, but Hillary took a huge fall down some stairs at the studio and ended up with some broken bones. Her excuse for it after didn't add up, only adding to her issues, since now it's clear that she's hiding something far worse than what she's ready to admit. Washington Examiner reports. Hillary Clinton canceled several media appearances Monday while on her book tour in London after she fell down the stairs and broke her toe. "I was running down the stairs in heels with a cup of coffee in hand. I was talking over my shoulder and my heel caught and I fell backwards," Clinton told the Graham Norton show. "I tried to get up and it really hurt. I've broken my toe. I've received excellent care from your excellent health service." While her excuse was made to sound like an innocent fall we've probably all suffered before, it doesn't make sense. She claimed that she simply fell backward and ended up with a broken toe. The logistics of a fall like that would cause one's feet to fly out in front, above them. With your feet in the air, it really makes it hard to break a toe. You could hurt a wrist catching yourself, a tailbone landing too hard, or other parts of the body, but a toe for falling backward is a difficult feat. Unless the fall was such a tangled, debaucherous mess that your feet got underneath you,